Hi there, I'm Diana from Office Timeline, and in this video we're going to explore two methods for creating timelines with milestones from your Microsoft Excel data. The first one is a manual method that uses the charts functionality directly in Excel to make a basic timeline. And the second one is a really fast and simple alternative that uses Office Timeline to take the data from your Excel file and turn it into a beautiful timeline in PowerPoint in just a matter of minutes. But before we get going, no matter which method you pick, you need to format your project data in Excel beforehand. Let's begin with that. First, list out your project's key events or milestones and give them titles. These milestones will form the basis of your timeline. Now add a due date for each milestone. We will also need a column with a repeating sequence of numbers, such as 1, 2, 3, 4. Excel will use these values to set the position of each milestone when plotting them on your timeline. Now make sure to save your file so you don't lose your data. And there you go, we have a data table that we'll use to create both of our timelines. Now let's make our first timeline directly in our Excel sheet. Click on any blank cell next to your data table, then go to the Insert tab. And in the Charts section, click on the Scatter or Bubble Chart icon. Then select the simple scatter chart. Excel has now created a blank chart on our sheet. Let's resize and move it to a better position. Then right-click on it and go to Select Data to open the Select Data Source window. We will now add the dates for our milestones to the graph, as well as set their positions. On the left side of this window, click Add. For the top field, select the title cell of your date column. For the middle field, shift select the dates. And for the bottom field, delete the existing text and shift select the values from the position column. Now that we've added the data to our chart, let's start tweaking the visual into an actual timeline. With the graph selected, click on this plus icon in its top right corner and uncheck chart title and grid lines. Then mouse over to the small arrow next to axis and uncheck primary vertical. Now go back to the previous part of this menu and check data labels and error bars. We'll now format these newly enabled elements to turn them into titles and connectors for our milestones. Let's start with the connectors. Click on the dates on the bottom of the timeline. Now right-click and select Format Axis. Now go to the newly appeared panel on your right and click the small arrow next to Axis Options. And then select the X Error Bars option. Now go to the Fill and Line menu and select No Line. Next, go back to the arrow near to Error Bar Options and this time select the Y Error Bars. Now click on the Error Bar Options icon, set the direction to minus and the error amount to percentage. Then set the value for that percentage to 100. And there you go. Your timeline's milestones now have connectors. Let's take care of our milestone titles next. Just like before, go to the side panel and click on the arrow next to Error Bar Options. Then select the Data Labels option and click the Label Options icon. Uncheck Y Value, but check Value from Cells, which will bring up the data label range window. Shift select the cells in your title column, click OK, and voila! The milestones in your timeline have titles now. Before we finish, let's adjust this graph to make it look a bit better. First, let's hide the connector lines behind our milestone titles by selecting the titles, clicking the Fill and Line icon, checking the solid fill box, and changing the fill color to white. Next, let's change the position of our milestones to make sure their titles don't overlap by tweaking the numbers in the position column. And let's remove some of the empty space to the left and right of our milestones by clicking on a date and changing the minimum and maximum bounds value. Now let's make each milestone have a different color by selecting any of them and in the right panel, click on the Fill and Line icon. Then on a marker, and in the Fill drop-down, select Vary Colors by Point. Finally, let's tweak the opacity of our connectors by selecting them. Then, in the right panel, set the transparency slider to 50%. And there you have it. With some considerable time and effort, we've managed to turn our Excel data into a basic timeline that we can copy and paste into our presentation. As you could see, the process in Excel was quite complicated, and making a timeline shouldn't be so hard. So I'd like to show you an easier way to create a timeline from your Excel data automatically, using Office Timeline. For this option, you'll need Office Timeline installed on your computer. This add-in works directly in PowerPoint and can pull data from Excel and other platforms to generate much more professional-looking visuals than what you can create with Excel alone. Let's take the data table we made at the start of this video and add one more column to the left of the table to include a row ID number for each of our items. This step is necessary if we want to update our Excel data after we have created our visual. Another thing we need to do is to add an empty column called Start Date and rename our Due Date column to End Date, then save the file. The reason we need to do this is because Office Timeline allows you to create tasks as well as milestones. Rows that have both a start and an end date filled in become tasks, while those with just one date filled in become milestones. In our case, since all our rows only have end dates, they will all become milestones. Now let's generate our timeline. Open up Microsoft PowerPoint. Go up here to switch over to the Office Timeline ribbon and click Import, and then select Excel. This will open up the Office Timeline Excel Import wizard. Use it to select your file, then make sure the table header containing the titles of each column is selected and that each column is properly mapped. And finally, select which rows you want to include in your visual. You can select all of them at once by clicking the check mark in the table header. When you're done, click Import, and Office Timeline will automatically generate your timeline visual in a matter of seconds. And if you edit the data in your Excel file, all you have to do to update the visual in PowerPoint is to save the newly edited file. Then, in PowerPoint, go to the Office Timeline ribbon and click Refresh Data. Ensure that the items you want to update are selected. Click Refresh, and Office Timeline will automatically adjust your visual to include your new edits. Pretty quick, right? Office Timeline also makes it easy to change the dates and layout of your timeline by letting you drag and drop items. To do that, go up here to Edit Timeline to open the timeline view. Drag this timescale to adjust the position of the entire chart. Then drag your milestones left or right to change their due date, or up and down to tweak the way they are laid out on the timescale. You can add tasks to your timeline as well, and you can adjust them by dragging in the same way you can do with milestones. You can also change the position of titles and dates. You can put your tasks and milestones into swim lanes and sub-swim lanes as well. Create a swim lane by clicking on this plus icon, then give it a title. Let's also add a sub-swim lane to it, just to see what it looks like. You can adjust their headers to take up less space, and you can drag items into them. Let's do some final adjustments to our layout, then click Save. And finally, let's make your visual even more eye-catching. You can either customize its styling in detail with the style pane if you have the time, or you can do what we're going to do and make it look really good in a few clicks by using a predefined theme. Go back to the Office Timeline ribbon and click on Themes. Then Manage and Apply Themes. Browse through the different pre-designed looks that come with the add-in until you find something that suits your timeline. There's a lot more you can do with Office Timeline, including showing dependencies and the critical path, and we cover those topics and more in our other videos, so do check them out when you have the time. When you're done, you can present your visual as is in PowerPoint. You can share it via email, or you can select Copy Timeline to Clipboard to paste it back into your Excel sheet or any other program that allows you to embed visuals into files. So there you have it, two different ways of creating a timeline from Excel data. While the first method might work for simple projects, Office Timeline is likely a better fit for more complex projects or if you need to present project updates to executives or stakeholders. Hope you found this video helpful. If so, remember to like and subscribe. And if you feel like giving Office Timeline a test run, come try the add-in for free by downloading it from officetimeline.com. See you next time!